In today's video, let's take a look at a special class of proof called proof without words. Typically, any general mathematical proof comes with either equations or written words to convince the readers of their validity. However, some proofs are deemed to be so self-evident that the authors do not bother adding any more words or equations beyond the minimum required. While some people find this class of proof elegant and beautiful, others might deem it a nuisance if they are not able to figure out what the author is trying to convey using only diagrams. Fortunately, our proofs today are simple enough to understand. We are trying to prove this famous formula that the first n positive integers sum up to n times n plus 1 divided by 2. For this, we are going to present two different proofs without words. Here is the first proof. Have you managed to figure out how this works? Don't fret if you haven't. We will add more words to the diagram to make things clearer as we go through the explanation. If you take a look at the number of balls along each of the row before we hit the dividing barrier, we can see that there are 1, 2, 3 balls and so on along each of the rows until we reach the nth row. On the other side of the dividing barrier, we have n, n minus 1, n minus 2 balls in that order until we reach 1 ball on the nth row. We see that adding up the balls, we get 2 times 1 plus 2 plus 3 up until plus n. Since we have n rows, and each row has n plus 1 balls each, we see that that's a total of n times n plus 1 balls. The number of balls must remain the same, no matter how we choose to add them up together. So, now we get the results. 2 times 1 plus 2 plus 3 until n equals n times n plus 1. Dividing by 2 gives the final result, as desired. This first proof was due to the ancient Greeks, apparently. The second proof was due to the mathematician, Ian Richards. Again, let's add more words and annotation to the original proof to illustrate the key concepts. If you assume that each square has an area of 1, and sum up the area of the diagram along each of the rows, then we get 1 plus 2 plus 3, up until plus n. If we try to sum the area in another way, this time by breaking it down to the big red right angle triangle and n blue small triangles, we see that the area of the big red triangle is given by half n square, since its side lengths are n, while each of the blue small triangles has area 1 half. If we add up the areas of these n blue triangles together with the big red triangle, we get n squared over 2 plus n over 2. This must then be the same as the first way we evaluate the area of the diagram. Hence, we arrive at the same conclusion. Proofs without words are not only pretty and beautiful in their own right, but they also illustrate the idea of evaluating the same quantity in two ways before equating two expressions. Such idea is also rather commonplace in general problem solving. We have come to the end of the video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Until then.